मार्च टू फ्रीडम, दिस इज द सीरीज ऑफ आर्टिकल्स फ्रॉम हार्टफुलनेस मैगजीन कलेक्टर्स एडिशन डिसम्बर 2017. दिस इज द फर्स्ट इन अ सीरीज ऑफ आर्टिकल्स बाय रिवर्ड कमलेश डी पटेल अबाउट द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस एंड हाउ स्पिरिचुअल प्रैक्टिसेस आर डिजाइंड टू हेल्प कॉन्शियसनेस एक्सपांड एंड इवॉल्व. रिवर्ड कमलेश पटेल टेक्स अस ऑन अ जर्नी, द अल्टीमेट जर्नी टू फ्रीडम. इन द प्रोसेस ही एक्सप्लेन्स व्हाई फ्रीडम इज ऑफ सच इम्पॉर्टेंस टू ह्यूमंस वर्ल्ड वाइड. इफ वी स्टडी हिस्ट्री, वी रियलाइज दैट देर आर सम फंडामेंटल प्रिंसिपल्स एंड वैल्यूज दैट द पीपल्स ऑफ ऑल कल्चर्स, बैकग्राउंड्स एंड वॉक्स ऑफ लाइफ हैव कंसिडर्ड इम्पॉर्टेंट. वी कैन कॉल देम यूनिवर्सल प्रिंसिपल्स. वन ऑफ द मोस्ट हाईली वैल्यूड इज फ्रीडम. इन द वर्ड्स ऑफ श्री रामचंद्र ऑफ शाहजहांपुर, द नेचुरल एर्निंग ऑफ द सोल इज टू बी फ्री फ्रॉम बॉन्डेज. दिस एर्निंग और क्रेविंग फॉर फ्रीडम इज द कोर ऑफ अवर ह्यूमन पर्पस. यू कुड से इन फैक्ट दैट द मार्च टू फ्रीडम इज अवर ट्रू ह्यूमन पर्पस. बट वॉट फ्रीडम इज रामचंद्र टॉकिंग अबाउट इन दिस स्टेटमेंट? Is it the license to do whatever we want on this earth for our own happiness at the expense of other people, other species and our environment? The ancient Greek philosopher Plato said no and argued that with freedom comes a responsibility to align our choices with goodness. In the 17th century, John Milton said the same thing. In the teachings of all religions, philosophies and spiritual traditions, we find the idea of choosing what is right or what is pleasurable. The Buddha's noble eightfold path is based on the same premise, as are the ethical precepts of yoga, yama and niyama, and the ten commandments of the Judeo-Christian tradition. So let's explore further Ramachandra's statement. The natural earning of the soul is to be free from bondage. What bondage? What is the bondage of the soul? All throughout this series on the evolution of consciousness, we have been very close to this theme. The evolution of consciousness is the expansion that comes step by step as we transcend the bondages of the soul. We have explored the three bodies of a human being. The soul is at the center of our existence, and then there are coverings around the soul. There are an infinite number of coverings around the soul, all of which can become heavy with complexities and impurities. Our real march to freedom is to purify these coverings so that they no longer bind the soul. To let the soul be free of all heaviness so it can soar and become one with the universal soul, we call the divine or God. To live in universal consciousness. This march to freedom is the spiritual journey, and there is a map to give us guidance and directions. This map is the spiritual anatomy of the human system. In earlier articles of this series, we started to explore spiritual anatomy, but now we will explore it in more depth. Many of you will have heard of chakras, which are often described as centers of concentrated energy in the human system. The traditional view is that there are seven main chakras. The first one is the root chakra at the base of the spine. The second one, the sacral chakra just below the navel. So first one is Muladhara or a root chakra. The second is the Swadhisthana or a sacral chakra. Third is solar plexus chakra in the upper abdomen. That is called Manipura or navel chakra. Fourth one is the heart chakra, Anahata. The fifth one is throat chakra or Vishuddhi chakra. Sixth one is the Bro Chakra or Agya Chakra, and seventh is द क्राउन चक्र एट द टॉप ऑफ द हेड और सहस्त्र दल कमल अ थाउजेंड पेटल्ड लोटस. But we now know that the spiritual anatomy of a human being is made up of many more chakras than these seven, and that they extend to the occipital prominence at the back of the head. The three lower chakras are common to all higher animal species, while human beings also have the possibility of awakening and developing the capacity of the chakras from the heart upwards. These 13 chakras are shown in this image. We can see in the front image, the first one on the left hand side, second on the right lower, third upper left, fourth upper right, then at the throat fifth, on the forehead sixth, seventh, eighth and ninth, then in the next name on the top of the head 10th chakra, then there is Sahasrdal Kamal, 11th towards back, and from back of the side 11th, 12th and 13th. The heart chakra is not just one star, it is a constellation of many stars, and the five major ones belong to the five elements that manifest throughout the universe: earth, air, fire, water and ether, also known as akasha or space. Our bodies are also made from those five elements which are present in the heart chakra, starting with chakra 1 of the heart, which has the qualities of earth dominant. The other four elements exist here to a lesser degree. Chakra 1 is on the lower left side of the chest near the physical heart. Chakra 2 is the soul chakra on the lower right side of the chest. It has the quality of space or akasha dominating. Chakra 3 is where the fire element dominates on the upper left side of the chest. Chakra 4 is where the water element dominates on the upper right side of the chest. And chakra 5 is at the throat and has the air element dominating. All of this is within the heart region or Pinda Pradesh, and it is a vast region in itself. Through the practice of heartfulness, the first step is to purify and awaken these five chakras of Pinda Pradesh so that consciousness can expand through this vast region. What does this mean for us? One thing it means is that we learn to purify and master the feelings side of life. We can clear away the overlays of emotional distortion around the soul and that color our perception, so that purity, wisdom and clarity become our natural state of being. We develop the confidence to listen to the heart. Our lives become simpler and purer. On this journey through the heart region at Chakra 1, we learn to work with our likes and dislikes, with the pull of our desires, including worldly worries, greed and jealousy, resentment and self-pity, sensuality and lust, guilt and shame. When we master these emotions as a result of purifying and traversing Chakra 1, a natural feeling of contentment and lightness develops. The beautiful thing about the earth element at Chakra 1 is that it supports and allows everything. It is utterly accepting without judgment. For instance, the earth will allow a murder to take place, and when it does, there is no earthquake. The earth does not swallow up the murderer. We walk on Mother Earth and she tolerates our weight. We can create a beautiful garden or burn the garden, and all is witnessed by the earth. She tolerates us. She accepts us. She is like a mother to us. When a person develops this quality at its pinnacle, that person becomes like a mother, becoming so loving and accepting of everything. At Chakra 2 is the spiritual heart. At Chakra 2, we experience the feelings of peace, lightness, stillness, and the bliss of the soul. Compassion reaches its zenith here. At first, It is difficult to integrate this experience with daily life, as the feelings are so enticing that all we want to do is meditate and stay in that state of peace. On one side, there is immense calmness and peace, and on the other side, a very subtle level of yearning to move onwards. Gradually, as we journey through Chakra 2 and balance Chakras 1 and 2, we learn to be both grounded in the earthly plane and soar in space at the same time. We start to integrate matter and spirit in our lives. This creates our base for moving onwards to the upper chakras in the chest area, where we encounter the other elements, fire, water, and air. Fire is vital energy, and at Chakra 3, we dive deeper into this element. Fire purifies. When you see gold or heated up, it is purified to produce gold. If you heat ice, what happens? It melts, it becomes water, which then becomes steam, powerful enough to move locomotive engines. Let us focus on these two principles of fire, purifying and melting. What is the solidity that melts in us? When we interact with people, sometimes we are vibrant and feel like moving, and at other times we don't feel like doing anything. We are frozen. It is just this. When the fire of love is there, we can move easily because love makes things easier and better. It is difficult to move around with complexities and heaviness. Fire has another quality. Even when you keep a match or a lighter pointing downwards, the fire will always rise upwards. Our love, the fire of love, must ascend. When we talk of ascension, we always talk of divinity. Love connects us with our source and with the guide who is leading us to our source. So love facilitates our march to freedom. At Chakra 3, we learn to use love and anger so that both are transformative, guiding emotions for this onward journey. Anger in its pure form is also for our benefit, as it alerts us to the fact that something is wrong and reminds us to change our tendencies and behaviors to continue on the right path. As we feel the inner friction, we know something needs refining. So at this chakra, the purifying effect of fire helps us to transform so that we evoke love in others. What is being transformed in us? The worst in us is being transformed. Things like hatred. It is transformed into love, and that's what helps us to ascend. Fire helps us to melt our heart. Here, true devotion develops and true love develops. We don't have to pretend to be in love, as we cannot help but love. Love becomes our very nature. When anger and love are directed elsewhere, when their focus is outwards, towards other people and things, these two emotions can drag us into entanglements and complexities, creating a diversion and causing emotional turbulence. That is not to say we should not love in a worldly sense, or that we should not utilize anger to improve ourselves in a worldly sense, but it is important to keep the field of consciousness clear and pure, as opposed to muddying it with turbulent emotions. Hence, we have the process of cleaning in heartfulness to refresh and rejuvenate the field of consciousness, to purify the subtle body on a daily basis. In our journey through the heart region, we purify all these feelings. Each one has its purpose, and we learn how to use them constructively for our onward evolution. Once we have traversed the chakras in the heart region, the journey then continues into higher and higher realms. To go further, the important quality that we need is generosity. Generosity of heart is able to drop the differences, the opposites, or the dvandas, and is able to discern things with just the right perspective. Moving to chakra 4, what does the water element evoke in us? Water has very soothing and tranquil effect. It refreshes our mind and soothes the heart. The state that we experienced with fire, always restless to love, now becomes quieter. The intensity of love is reduced considerably. Love becomes like a deep flowing river towards the source. It is less expressive and more inwardly transporting. The emotional excitement of love found at chakra 3 is enabled when it combines with the water element and becomes subtler. Strength develops from within as love flows deeper, and this manifests at chakra 4 as courage and confidence in everything that we do. Courage is very beneficial when a healthy level of humility and concern for others is present. But when it is reckless and ego-driven, it can be destructive. At chakra 4, we also experience and learn to master fear. Let's say you are all alone on the ocean and there are 30-foot waves. You will feel afraid. Fear balances courage, preventing us from doing things that could be reckless. It keeps us on track, if you like, in its pure form, but when it is weighed down with impressions, fear can become negative and crippling. Chakra 5 is dominated by the air element and has qualities of lightness, clarity, and intelligence. Air is always in flux. We don't know which direction it is heading. In the same way, our mind, our moods, our emotions also keep on fluctuating. At chakra 5, there can be a lot of illusion. When heaviness or emotional turbulence exists in the heart, the air element manifests this confusion and illusion. When confusion is present, it means that we must pause and wait until the confusion has shifted and the heart is able to truly guide us with clarity. In our journey through the heart region, we purify all these feelings. Each one has its purpose, and we learn how to use them constructively for our onward evolution. Once we have traversed the chakras in the heart region, the journey then continues into higher and higher realms. To go further, the important quality that we need is generosity. Generosity of heart is able to drop the differences, the opposites or the dvandvas, and is able to discern things with just the right perspective. Transcending this Pinda Pradesh means going beyond the earthly plane of existence to the mind region, and finally beyond the mind region to the central region. We will explore these regions next time in the quest to understand more of the march to freedom. Here we conclude first part. We will commence with next part in next video. Please do visit www.heartfulnessmagazine.com and www.shpt.in. Thank you for listening.